Today we highlight communication and leadership, which, as the title indicates, confirms the strong relationship between the two, communication and leadership. I am José Manuel García-Lomas Allen-Perkins. Everything is communication. We cannot not communicate. As leaders, our image and expression always accompany us. We have already spoken about the power of word in others. If we communicate in positive, you influence in positive. If we communicate in negative, the influence is negative. The leader shows through himself, which is important, facts, not words. The leader exemplifies the ideal in action, leads by example, he is paradigmatic. Paradigm, example or exemplary, something that serves as an example or model of how things should be done. Leadership is about service. The leader gives wings to his followers by transforming them through the Pygmalion effect. That is to say, through the potential of influence that the belief of the leader exercises on the performance of his followers. Since the expectations or belief that the leader places on his followers have the potential to modify their behavior, making them fulfill these expectations. But let's go back to communication and leadership. Let's start with the development of the attention curve in our communication as leaders. As we see in our diagram, within the axis of coordinates, we place in the vertical axis, called the order, the attention given to us by an interlocutor or a group of people who are addressing. While in the horizontal axis, called abscissa, we place the time factor. In this way, when we begin our presentation, we must ensure that the attention of the interlocutor of the group grows as the time of our presentation passes, developing a curve called the attention curve, which will reach a maximum point after a certain time, and from which the attention declines and falls. Therefore, we have a limited time to capture the group's attention and keep it in crescendo before the group's attention declines and falls apart and they stop painful attention to us. We are not discovering anything new, because how many of us in many occasions, talking with someone, we capture that by their lost look or by answers that are not relevant, we realize that that person has already lost the attention and is being showered with my words, by my message no longer penetrates it. This will be a sign that the attention curve, for whatever reason, has dropped so much that they no longer listen to me. And the question is, how do we get a good development of our attention curve? First, with a good content, is to say the what do we say, and secondly, with a good form in saying the how do we say it. When content and form are properly integrated, we will achieve the result of a magnificent attention curve that goes in crescendo, which will guarantee that the attention of the speaker, whether a person or an audience, is maintained in time and that they can capture the message that I am transmitting, and hopefully with all the intention that I put forward my message. In previous videos, we have conveniently developed within the oral expression techniques the way we speak, how we say it, that we saw was constituted by two aspects already treated of: one, how to use our voice with 10 points, and two, our appearance with 3 points covered. Today we enter into the development of the second vital component in the attention curve and in our communication as it is, the content, what we say, with 3 important phases. The first, the opening, our beginning. Secondly, the theme which we deal with. And third, the closing, our end. These 3 phases, from a commercial point of view, are called the ABC of our presentation, which corresponds to the phases of attention, benefits, and close. And something that should be stressed, remembering that famous phrase that nothing replaces deep preparation. We will have to plan how begin by pulling strongly on the attention curve in the introduction phase. Attention, carefully planning the presentation of our theme, benefit structuring this phase and the audiovisual media we plan to use, and finally plan also carefully how we are going to conclude, how we are going to close the closing. Now, and because of our performance, both individual and in public, the question is how to overcome the state of nerves, tension, fear in front of the interlocutor or the group, the stage fright. It is quite common to feel tension, nervousness, prevention, or fear in front of the group at the beginning of our speech. It is a natural feeling since we do not know who we are talking to. We do not know what the group's reaction will be, nor when the first objection will come up, nor what it will be. Besides, the group studies us. We are going to give some general rules for overcoming stage fright. 1. The group doesn't notice more than 10% of the possible nervousness you have. 2. You must not avoid it. You must control it. In the short term, what to do? Deep abdominal breathing, yogic breathing. At first, look at warm-looking, friendly people. Do not look at unpleasant faces at first. They make us nervous. If we have a dry mouth, have a glass of water at hand and do it yourself. Write the first sentence with which we start the speech. Take good poses and use them for deep abdominal breathing. If there are problems with the hand, use a pen at first, but then stop promptly. And in the long run, what to do? Prepare well for our presentation. Good knowledge of the subject. Training with clock and video. And remember, nothing replaces a thorough preparation. The goal that oratory pursues: transmit, communicate, create interest in the group by being accepted by it, to break the psychological barrier that exists between the group and the speaker, to make feel what I feel. That is why we have a certain similarities with an actor. We develop a role. Characteristics for a good exposure. A good performance or exposure in front of the group is not in itself the objective. Good performance should not distract the participants from the content of the presentation. Do not make a show. good sponsors should be adapted to the group. Create interaction between the speaker and the group. The golden rule is don't talk to the group, but within the group. Rules for a good show. Make every effort to make the group want to listen to you and trust you. Speak naturally and spontaneously. Be yourself. Commit to what you are saying. Don't hesitate. Don't be too eclectic. Beware of pontificating, dogmatizing. Never show a lack of interest in what you are saying. And let's get into the techniques of oral expression techniques. Public speaking, the content, what we say. 1. The opening, our beginning. Were the objectives of our presentation clearly defined? Did it have the right impact to capture attention? 2. The theme we address. And within the theme, A. The structure. Did it stay on topic? Were the stages presented in a logical sequence? Was there a correct sequence throughout the presentation of the theme, red line? B. The exposition. How was the verbal fluency, ability to find words and phrases and use them to communicate? Are the key points of the speech emphasized? Was the presentation of the topic concise and exact? Was the content technically correct? Did I reach the objectives? Was the entire content of the report necessary? C. Visual aids. Did you use the right aids? Did you use them properly? Did you use yourself as a visual aid? D. Contact with the group. Did you have a good contact with the group? Were you always audible? Did you avoid criticism or sarcasm? Was the group actively involved during the report? 3. The closing, our end. Was a summary made? Did the summary cover all the key points? Was the follow-up clearly defined? With all this, we covered the basic elements of oral expression techniques, public speaking. Well, in upcoming videos, we will continue to delve into different aspects of this important communication topic. And, okay, if you are interested in our videos, I suggest you give a like and subscribe to our channels in Spanish and in English, as we publish videos every week.